Conflicts between animals resulting in serious harms are very common in nature. In this video, we are going to see the most common ones. We'll first see the ones that take place among animals of the same species. Afterwards, we will examine harms due to conflicts with animals of other species. Animals have many different kinds of conflicts with other members of their own species. Animals fight to secure food, territory, mates, or social status within a group. Some animals eat members of their own species. Fighting can result in injury or death. We'll look at some of these harms. Territoriality is a widespread cause of intraspecific conflict. It occurs when an individual animal defends a particular territory against intrusion by other animals and thereby maintains exclusive access to food, nesting sites, or mates. Animals use a variety of methods to demarcate and defend their territories, from scents to sounds to ritual displays. Sometimes, however, animals use force to defend their territories, and this means risking injury or even death for the defender or the intruder. Many species of birds are territorial, at least during the mating season, and some will fight to defend their territory. These fights can be brutal, leaving one or both parties with painful injuries. Blackbirds are extremely territorial, with both males and females fighting to protect their territory. Intergroup violence is common among chimps. Such conflicts usually center around control of territory or the kidnapping of fertile females. Big cats are frequently territorial. Tigers are generally solitary, maintaining individual territories. Generally, fights over territory result in the weaker individual submitting, though sometimes injury or death can result. Many species of ant are highly territorial. Honey ants have specialized workers called repletes. The repletes are fed by the other workers and are used as living larders, storing honey for the winter. When one colony is significantly stronger than another, it will raid the weaker colony, killing or driving away the queen, enslaving the workers, and capturing the honey-rich repletes to feed their own colony. In order to access the honey, the workers chew through the abdomen of the replete. Polygyny is a mating system in which a single male lives and mates exclusively with multiple females. This system has been observed in elephant seals, gorillas, pheasants, and baboons. Since the numbers of males and females in most species are approximately equal, polygynous mating systems lead to competition between males for access to females. Elephant seal males fight to control a beach and thereby have exclusive mating rights over the females in that territory. A successful male can have a harem of up to 100 females, while most males will not have a chance to mate at all. The fights between males can be brutal, especially when the males are evenly matched. Having offspring is generally a much bigger investment of resources for females than it is for males. It is females who undergo pregnancy or lay eggs, who provide most of the parental care, and in mammals who provide milk for their young. Male investment of energy and resources is much lower. Males therefore tend to adopt a reproductive strategy which focuses on maximizing their number of mates, while females tend to adopt a strategy of having fewer, higher quality mates. Males coerce females into mating with them by physically forcing them to mate, harassing them until they accede, or by punishing refusals to mate. Sexual coercion is common among animals of many species, including insects, fishes, birds, such as some species of waterfowl, bottlenosed dolphins, and primates. The victim usually struggles and attempts to escape and is often mobilized by the attacker. In some cases, it results in severe injury from actions like scalping, tearing the skin over the head in waterfowl. The rape attempts can be made individually or in groups, like the rape flights performed by groups of drakes. The risk of injury is high, and the severity of the act may lead to drowning of the assaulted victim. In social animals, social status is important, because a higher rank may mean better access to mates and resources like food and territory. Chimpanzees have been witnessed killing members of their own groups over social status, mating rights, in apparent political power struggles. Sometimes the loser in a power struggle is chased away, and sometimes attacked or killed. In our video about psychological stress, I talk about other ways that animals can be harmed in social groups. Cannibalism is common in nature. In many cases, cannibalism is practiced on infants. In some cases, this allows the cannibal to eliminate the progeny of a rival. In other cases, it is the parent who kills and sometimes consumes their own children. This behavior has been observed in fishes, birds, rats, sloths, and beetles. It isn't always clear what causes parents to kill their own children. In some cases, it may be to cut their losses or recoup the energy expended in a bad investment. For example, if the infants are developing too slowly, are sick, or there isn't enough food for them all. The parent might be starving or stressed due to difficult environmental conditions. In some cases, parents kill their offspring in order to make themselves available for mating so that they can try again for a better brood. Whenever an animal has multiple offspring at once, there is the potential for sibling rivalry. Food and parental attention are limited. In situations where the resources available aren't sufficient, either because of poor environmental conditions or the large size of the brood, siblings have to compete with each other for the resources they require. Siblicide is frequently observed in birds. Nazca boobies are large seabirds, and the chicks almost always engage in siblicide. The mother lays one or two eggs in each clutch. The first chick is usually born around 5 days before the second and almost invariably kills the younger sibling by dragging him from the nest. Spotted hyena cubs are born with their eyes open and with developed teeth and begin fighting each other shortly after birth. These fights function to establish rank, but in times of intense food competition, they can result in death. The strongest cubs may not kill the weakest directly, but they can limit their access to their mother's milk, eventually starving them to death. Conflicts between animals of different species are very common. Of course, one example of this is when some animals are killed by others, although there are also other types of conflicts. The vast majority of the animals who exist are invertebrates, due to which conflicts of this kind are more numerous among them. Animals may be killed and eaten in varied ways. The amount of time it takes before the victim is killed also varies. Sometimes small animals like invertebrates may be killed by the digestive enzymes of other animals, which start to break down the animal's body into a liquid form. Depending on the kind of venom and the size of the species of the captured animal, they may still be alive and capable of feeling pain during this process. Some others are eaten while they are still alive instead of being killed first. Among them, some may be swallowed and digested alive, while others may be disemboweled while still alive. Animals who avoid being captured also suffer in a variety of ways from the presence of other animals, whom they perceive as a threat in their environment. When they share an environment with them, they may suffer from psychological distress, as well as poor nutrition, because they don't dare graze in places where they are very visible. Hunting is a dangerous activity. It is common for predators to be injured or killed while hunting. They can suffer from accidents by losing their footing in high-speed chases over difficult terrain. If the injury is severe enough, animals may die of starvation.